For thousands of years, whenever the human race has looked up at the night sky, we've been caught in awe, watching heavenly objects scattered as far as the eye can see. We've always wondered what it would be like to visit those places, and if there's anybody out there. Well, thanks to countless inventions and discoveries over the past few centuries by great scientists, our technology is now advanced enough that we can send probes to distant planets with pinpoint accuracy. And we're even planning to send the first humans to other planets. But before we can colonize an entire planet, it makes sense to first test ourselves on a smaller scale, which is exactly what NASA is planning to do with their Artemis mission, which will see humans colonize the moon by as early as 2024. Most of us don't think of it this way, but we are a colonizing race. And there's already one planet that we've colonized. It's the one that we live on now. Our story started in Africa about 300,000 years ago. And today we've spread all over the planet. Now that we've occupied Earth, the next logical destination is our moon, the closest special object to us. And I think it would be safe to say that when NASA sent the first humans there for the first time in 1969, the idea of colonizing it officially began. Even though it might not have been the intention then, it's only obvious that the first step of colonizing a place is to actually visit it. We landed 5 more times on the lunar surface after the first mission, but due to monetary and political reasons, we stopped visiting. However, technology kept on improving over the years, and now we're more than capable of not only sending humans back to the moon, but also establishing a base of some sort, and officially kickstarting its colonization. NASA's Artemis Mission. NASA's mission to put humans on the moon again and set up a permanent presence there is called the Artemis program. It was launched back in 2017 and will be an international effort to achieve the goals of the program. Space agencies and private companies from all over the world will be involved in the program, and each nation will play a crucial role in its success. The top two leading the mission, however, are NASA and SpaceX. The program is being conducted in a very systematic manner with clear-cut, predefined goals for the future. The short-term goal includes landing the first woman on the moon. The mid-term goal is to establish an international expedition team and to ensure a sustainable human presence there. The long-term goal is perhaps the most exciting one, since it involves building a local economy and turning the moon into a pit stop for manned missions to Mars and beyond. So now that we know the broader details of the program, let's get down to the nitty-gritty. How does NASA plan to achieve such a Herculean task? Well, rockets are involved for sure. But you already knew that, didn't you? What you may not have known is that there are 4 components involved that will all play a critical role in helping us achieve the goals of the program, even the long-term ones. The 4 components are as follows. 1. The SLS rocket. 2. The Orion spacecraft. 3. The Lunar Gateway. And 4. The human landing system. It's vital to understand the role of each component in the overarching program. This structure could become the go-to way of any deep space missions in the future and the colonization of other planets and moons. So let's take a look at each component in more detail. The SLS rocket. The Space Launch System rocket will be what launches the astronauts off the planet. Once completed, it will be the most powerful and capable rocket in the world, and will be able to deliver a payload of about 130 tons into low Earth orbit. This will come in handy because the SLS is supposed to launch the Orion spacecraft outside Earth's atmosphere. However, unlike SpaceX's Falcon 9 rockets, the SLS is not reusable. NASA began the development of this rocket back in 2011 and is still yet to complete it. The Orion spacecraft. This spacecraft will sit on top of the SLS rocket and will house the astronauts heading towards the moon. In the future, it might also be used for missions to Mars. It's a partially reusable spacecraft built by Lockheed Martin and is designed to carry up to 6 astronauts beyond low Earth orbit. The crew module of the spacecraft is the only part that will return to Earth, hence the partial reusability status. It will even have a launch abort system in case things go wrong and the astronauts have to eject to safety. Currently, Lockheed is constructing 3 of these spacecrafts for the Artemis mission, and a 4th one has recently been ordered by NASA. The Lunar Gateway. This will be a space station like the International Space Station, but much smaller. It will be built specifically for the Moon, and will keep orbiting it for well over a decade. The Lunar Gateway will be a hub for solar-powered communication, transfers of astronauts, a science laboratory, short-term habitation, and much more. This component of the Artemis program will be jointly made by NASA, the European Space Agency, the Canadian Space Agency, and the Japanese Aerospace Exploration Agency. The Lunar Gateway is planned to be constructed in stages beginning in 2022. The Human Landing System. Now for the final piece of the puzzle. The Human Landing System will allow astronauts to land on the surface of the Moon and come back up to the Gateway. It will consist of a lander vehicle that can safely carry astronauts to and from the Moon. NASA chose to partner with private space companies for this system. The contenders were SpaceX, Blue Origin, Dynetics, Boeing, and Vivace. Due to SpaceX's insanely advanced Starship HLS lander, NASA selected it for the Artemis program. To that end, on the 16th of April 2021, NASA awarded SpaceX with a $2.89 billion contract to develop the Starship HLS lander for the Artemis mission. The lander will reportedly be able to carry up to 200 tons to the lunar surface, but will first make its way to the Gateway from Earth using SpaceX's own Super Heavy rocket. NASA has asked SpaceX to provide 2 Starship HLS landers by 2025. Can NASA pull it off? As we speak, there are only 4 months left in 2021, and it seems like NASA might struggle to hit the 2024 target. There are just way too many moving parts, and everything needs to be coordinated perfectly. Plus, there needs to be rigorous testing of every component before astronauts can be sent to the Moon. In fact, NASA will have unmanned Artemis missions to check the viability of all the components before involving humans, which will take up even more time and resources. The Artemis 1 mission will be a test flight of sorts that will test the SLS and an unmanned Orion spacecraft. This is the first mission coming up in November 2021. This will be followed by the Artemis 2 mission, which will be the first manned flight test of the SLS and the Orion spacecraft. It will help us understand whether the Orion spacecraft is suitable for longer durations, keeping in mind future missions to deep space. It's scheduled to launch in 2022, and 4 astronauts will be sent to the lunar orbit and back. The Artemis 3 mission is what we're all excited for. This mission is scheduled for launch in 2024 and expects to land the first woman and the next man on the Moon. Although 4 astronauts will be sent on the Orion spacecraft, only 2 astronauts will land on the Moon. There, they'll remain on the surface of the Moon for 6.5 days. With so much work still left in the pipeline, it seems like the Artemis project might get delayed. Also, a lot depends on the success of the Artemis 1 and 2 missions. Any failure would result in even more delays. Even if we don't get there by 2024, one thing you can be sure of is that humans will colonize the Moon by the end of this decade, which, if you ask me, is a pretty crazy thing to think about. And that's a wrap. What are your thoughts on the Artemis mission? Can you see humans setting up a permanent civilization there? Let us know what you think by leaving a comment down below. As always, I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, don't forget to subscribe to the channel to stay updated whenever we release a new one. Other than that, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.